Hey everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm Damian. I'm joined by George Verghese. George, what are we talking about today?
So today we're going to be talking about the Azure DevOps CLI, what it can do, and what it is.
Nice. Don't miss it. Hi everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I am Damian Brady and I am in Australia at the moment, but I'm joined by George Verghese, who is all the way over in India. George, thanks for joining me.
Thanks a lot, Damian.
Yeah, so George, you are on the Azure DevOps team, focusing on the Azure CLI or the Azure DevOps CLI, correct?
That's right.
Okay, so for those who aren't aware, what is the Azure DevOps CLI?
So the Azure DevOps CLI lets you experience Azure DevOps from the command line. It is distributed as an extension to Azure CLI, so it gets all the advantages of Azure CLI in terms of being cross-platform and being available on Bash, command line, and PowerShell, and even on the Cloud Shell.
So this is a tool that I use fairly regularly. This is the AZ command line thing. So whenever you're exploring basically anything in Azure, so Azure DevOps is an extension to that. So you can continue to use the AZ command line stuff, but now you're talking to Azure DevOps too.
That's right. In addition to all the other great extensions and all the resources available in Azure CLI, you will now be able to use the same interaction canvas to talk to Azure DevOps as well.
That's really cool. So let's start from how you actually get started with this. So I know that it's relatively easy to install the Azure CLI. How easy is it to install the Azure DevOps extension on top of that?
It is just like installing any other extension on Azure CLI. You just need to add an extension by using AZ extension add and just provide Azure DevOps as the name for the extension. It's just as simple as that.
Okay. And then once you have that added, there's just a whole bunch of more commands that you can use for Azure DevOps, correct?
Yes. Let me show you what all commands we expose with inclusion of the AZ DevOps module. So along with the Azure DevOps module, you get the top level commands of AZ DevOps, AZ pipelines, AZ boards, AZ repos, and AZ artifacts. These are the fundamental pillars of the DevOps service.
Okay, cool. So these will give you further commands like inside those, which will let you do things with pipelines or with boards or with repos, correct?
That's right.
Okay. So without going in too much into it, I just want to attack this first. You're running this just from a command line in Windows, right? But AZ is cross-platform. So the AZ DevOps extension would be cross-platform as well. So you don't have to be using Windows.
That's right. You can use it from Bash in terms of your Linux OS or your Mac OS, whatever suits you best.
Okay. And so there's that part of it. The other side of it is this isn't the only way to access Azure DevOps from a command line tool or from like programmatically, is it? There's also the REST API and then there's the VS Team PowerShell thing that that Donovan Brown has created. Why use the CLI over those ones?
Right. So from our customers, we've learned that it is better than the REST API because it handles the authentication module better. And since the CLI is an easier abstraction model on top of the REST API, it's a little easier interacting with the CLI over the REST API. In terms of Donovan Brown's VS Teams, it's more a preference module. Like people who require more PowerShell native commanding, then VS Teams would be a better choice. But in terms of a proper CLI, it might be a better choice to go with the Azure CLI.
Yeah, I guess if you're already using the AZ command line for other things, let's say you have a bunch of stuff where you're creating an app service, and then you also want to talk to Azure DevOps to create a task in the board or something like that, you don't have to leave and use a different tool. You can continue to use the same tooling.
Correct. That's absolutely right. Yep.
Yep. But yeah, again, it's just a choice. Like it's another thing that we can do, which is great. All about giving us choices.
Yeah, exactly. So, everyone's free to do what suits them the best.
Okay. So let's drill into the tool itself a little bit more. You did an AZ DevOps -H, and I think that's also, you can do --help as well, and that will just give you some information. How do I find out about those kind of top level things, what we can do in those top levels like pipelines?
So any command that you need help with, there is, you can quickly jump into the documentation by using the --help. And we generally, for detailed topics, we provide link outs to our documentation portal, where you can learn in detail about all the commands, all the parameters. We also provide a snippet of that information in each command help. So imagine you need help with AZ pipelines create. You just hit help, and you should have all the information to get you started.
All right. So you can kind of explore and keep going down the tree to get the information that you need.
That's right. Yes.
Okay. So that will help you kind of explore what commands are available. What kind of things would you expect people would want to do with this tool? Like, what are the key kind of use cases that you'd expect people to use with this extension?
Right. So one of the things that we've heard is, one is straight out interaction, which is, I can show you along the way on how easy it is to set up things like pipelines from a repo using the CLI tool, because usually developers are already in the CLI tooling for the Git commands, and therefore it becomes very, very simple to interact with DevOps from the command line. The other piece is the automation piece, which people predominantly use it to script automation and automate a lot of their custom workflows as their preference. So it gives them a complete canvas for doing whatever they want to automate. So we've heard, you know, automation requirements around scripting their entire Azure DevOps project setup and, you know, other use cases like that. So it's fundamentally interaction and automation.
I'd actually heard somebody speaking to, I spoke to somebody yesterday who was doing exactly that. They wanted to, every time there was a new project that started up in their org, they wanted to be able to script the creation of the entire Azure DevOps pipeline that they're using. So they were using the AZ DevOps extension, which is quite cool.
Yeah, that's been a very common scenario that we've been hearing, and we have actually set up a sample script in our repo for people to quickly pull.
Oh, awesome. Well, we'll put those details in the show notes as well if people are looking for that particular solution. But let's go back to this first one where you were talking about an interactive flow. So the command line is not really where I would expect, you know, to find an interactive flow. But can you show us what that would look like to create a pipeline from the command line?
Awesome. So to start off this example, so I'm in a local checkout of an sample express app. To see what it looks like, I have the local instance running, and it's a quick sample app. And you can create a pipeline using the command az pipelines create hyphen name, and just provide a name for the pipeline. Now, what the command is actually doing is, I have the organization and project I'm planning to target set up in the defaults. Post this command run, I can show you that. The other piece is that, you know, all the information regarding the repo in terms of where it's residing is being pulled up from the Git config. So today, Express app has been hosted on GitHub. So we support GitHub and Azure repos as repo sources from where you can build pipelines. You know, so all the intelligence around where it's dying, what is the details required, is being pulled up from the context, right?
Great.
And as the initial step, Azure Pipelines needs a service connection to communicate with GitHub. So I have a service connection set up, so I'm going to reuse it at this point. So this is about what I mean by interactive, where you don't need to remember a lot of parameters to come play or create a pipeline from the CLI. So once that is done, the pipelines has gone and analyzed the repo and suggested some of the best templates that are possible. For this example, I will take deploy to Azure Kubernetes service.
Right. So these lists aren't standard lists. It's based on what the repo contains. Is that correct? Or the ones that it makes sense float up to the top?
Yes, this is based on what the repo contains. And, you know, becoming an extension to Azure CLI, we get what is the default subscription that you're running in. So immediately we can go and check what are the Kubernetes clusters which you want to target and which you have on your subscription. So it makes it super simple for people to get started.
So this is one of the big advantages of using the AZ extension over like PowerShell or the REST API or something, because you have the Azure context, not just the Azure DevOps context.
That's right. So you can always plug into the resources in Azure using your subscription. So here, post-analyzing what are the Kubernetes namespace, we get, you know, the next question is around where do you want to, which Azure Container Registry do you want to deploy to? And I have only one here, and we continue down the flow. And it's fundamentally what it's doing is it's finding information in terms of where to deploy the image and then go on to deploying it to the Kubernetes cluster. So okay. at this point, it's running to see, you know, what is it is pipelines is actually trying to see, you know, what are the additional information that is required in addition to the resource readiness. It is also checking, analyzing the YAML to see, analyzing to see what is the default port and, you know, what is the image name defaults that needs to be recommended. Okay. So as you can see, it suggested a default name for the image. I'm just going to stick with the default. And actually the port is 3000. And once that is done, it's generated the pipeline YAML, at which point I can either continue blindly with the generated YAML, or for now, I'm just going to show you that you can view and edit the YAML as well at this point. So all the hard work has been done. You've got the complete pipeline YAML generated. Wow. You can view it and edit it if you require before you come at it.
So where does this file exist? Is this just stored in a temporary location so you can view it and modify it?
That's right. For now, it is in a temporary location. You can modify it if you want. And once you're happy with the file, you can go ahead and commit it to master.
Right.
So I'm going to proceed with this YAML. And it is saying that it's going to add three additional files, which is the manifest as well as the Azure Pipelines.yaml. So I'm going to commit directly to master. So I've got my GitHub path in my environment variable. So what happens with the Azure DevOps extension at this point is that it is actually checking to see whether there is a path which is already provided. If not, it is going to request you for your credentials before committing into the GitHub repo.
Right. Okay. So this is literally doing absolutely everything, including the auth and the building of the YAML and the kicking off the build and all that kind of stuff.
Yep. It's got all the magic in. And in addition to that, you can see that the pipeline has been built and the pipeline run has been kicked off. So you can use the AZ pipeline runs list command to actually go see what are the pipeline runs associated for a particular pipeline. So you can see that the pipeline ID is 501, and I'm just going to use that to list all the runs for this pipeline.
Okay, so this is your new pipeline. So presumably that'd only be the one, correct?
Yeah, that's right. I made a small typo error here. So there's only one run, and you can quickly always switch out from the command line to the browser if you want to see the details of this particular run by using a simple open switch. So you can say pipeline runs show and provide the pipeline run ID and just include the open switch. So what it does is it shows the exact, it will navigate you to the exact pipeline run on the Azure DevOps portal. And you can see that it is currently being building and it will go on to the deploy stage.
Wow, that's really impressive.
So you have complete flexibility of just staying within the CLI or moving to the Azure DevOps portal.
Right. So this was kind of the interactive story where you built that up as you went. If you wanted to turn that into a template, you were talking about kind of parameterizing those commands, and that's kind of the automation story or the scaffolding story. Can we have a look at how that story works?
Awesome. So one of the things, so we have all the examples in our repo, which is on GitHub, which is the Azure DevOps CLI extension repo.
Okay, and we'll put a link to that in the notes as well.
Yep. So within that, we have the scaffolding folder where we have the script. And I'm just going to quickly pull it up in an editor to show you what it's like. So we have scripted using the Azure DevOps CLI. in PowerShell. So it's a PowerShell script. And what it really does is it goes into the creation flow. So it creates a project, it creates a repo, it builds in a branch policy of optional reviewers and required reviewers, and it builds out the team and the area and the iterations. So how it works is there's a bunch of information that is being captured. So you can either use it as a separate file. So we provided a file where you can put in all the information that is required, or you can go into individual commands and provide it as a parameter input. For ease of this example, I'm just going to use it as an org details file, which is capturing all the details.
Okay. And I should point out as well, you're using PowerShell here purely because that's comfortable for you. But if you're in Linux, you might want to use Bash. If you're...
Yep.
I mean, even if you're writing code yourself, you could run these commands, you know, by just running something on the command line, and it would still be the same thing.
Exactly. That's right. So whatever Canvas suits you best, you are free to choose that. So for now, I'm going to just update a few parameters, and I'm just going to include few real users. So you can quickly run the scaffolding PowerShell script and provide file path to all the parameters that we have captured in the org details text. And this should kickstart the automation flow.
If you want to have a look at that, go to that repo that's available, and we'll put that in the show notes as well, and just have a look at some of those samples for scaffolding to see how you can add that to your own project.
Good, yes. That should give you a good starting point with the automation flows as well.
Okay, great. Awesome. Thanks so much for showing us this. This actually goes into a lot more depth than I was expecting, to be honest. And something that's really handy, especially if you're using the AZ tool already, or the AZ command line already.
That's right. So it gives you an easy way, an easy companion to interact with Azure DevOps.
Yeah, awesome. Okay, well, thank you so much, George. And it's been really cool talking to you from a whole other country. It's nice to be able to do that in different time zones.
Yep, awesome. It's been awesome talking to you. Thanks for having me, Damian.
Awesome. All right, and thanks, everybody, for joining us. Join us for another DevOps Lab sometime soon.